Next, we'll look at something of a dilemma facing today's grain growers. In the past 30 years, we've come to see tillage as something to be avoided if we can, and that shift has given grain growers huge benefits. But is there a case for strategic or occasional tillage?
I've been zero tilling here for 20 odd years, minimum till, probably even longer.
Like almost 90% of Queensland's grain growers, Rodney Hamilton chooses zero till as his farming system of choice. But after two decades without soil disturbance, last year he hooked up a chisel plough and kicked up some dirt. It was all part of a trial on the impact of strategic tillage on productivity, profitability and soil health.
One of the major problems we are facing with the no-till farming system is the build-up of hard-to-kill weeds, build-up of soil and stubble-borne diseases, nutrient stratification, some soil compaction in some areas. These are some of the major issues we are facing with the no-till farming system. So we need to bring some flexibility into the system. And probably one-time occasional tillage could be an answer.
But at what cost? The big fear for growers is even a single till pass will undo the benefits accumulated over decades.
The wildlife is built up in the soil and the worms and just all the biology that surrounds zero till has just been so beneficial, and I would hate to see that destroyed.
The impact of occasional tillage in zero till systems is what a series of GRDC projects aims to find out. And if the turnout at this field day is anything to go by, grower interest is high.
But today I'm talking about bringing tillage back. Whether I'm advocating that or not, that you have to decide yourself.
Midway into this three-year project, the number of trial sites has risen from 5 to 9, with the effects of soil disturbance using chisel plough, offset disc and Kelly chain measured against no-till.
Early results suggest that one-time tillage in no-till farming system helped control winter weeds, improved productivity and profitability, at the same time without compromising with the soil health benefits of the no-till farming system. But these are very preliminary results yet.
Profitability improved on all four of the project's trial sites, with an average grain yield increase of 100 kilograms per hectare.
That resulted into profitability of around $2 to $35 in different trials.
Yash emphasises those results could be due to good rainfall, both in crop and between tillage and sowing.
Getting the reliable rains after the introduction of tillage is very important.
Results across all sites include a significant reduction in weed densities, but also reduced soil moisture and bug density in the top 10 centimetres. Topsoil phosphorus and organic carbon was redistributed into the subsoil, a benefit rather than a detriment to productivity. And while microbial activity reduced at several sites, it increased at one site. With only one season studied so far, growers will be watching subsequent results for definitive answers.
No one is suggesting we return to the days of the plough, but it's interesting that tillage may have a place in our modern conservation farming systems.
Tillage in higher rainfall seasons might offer growers flexibility in how they manage a heavy weed or disease burden or herbicide resistance, while providing benefits through soil aeration and nutrient redistribution. And less reliance on herbicides means less cost, both financial and environmental. But for growers to make informed decisions, more information is needed.
We are very much concerned. What would be the frequency of this tillage? How often we have to do this tillage? Do we have to do this tillage every year? That's one of the biggest questions with us. And when we should do this tillage?
This project is working towards finding answers.
The question that each grower will ask themselves is, do I do a tillage? Often, and this is my take on it, is that they don't have any options, so they may be forced into a tillage as much as they don't want to because of their weed spectrum. And I believe that's okay. It's a management decision that each grower will make in the end.